Nice. Let's continue. Ah, fuck. Give me a sec. Yeah, that's supposed to be fine.
お邪魔します。
うん、いらっしゃい。もうそろそろ出来上がるから。
ああ、おいしそう。
ねえ。The fears that rain at the table started over me.
せっかくの機会だから、腕にヨリをかけたのよ。
ありがとうございます。
でも、ちょっと多すぎたかな。この後は自転車に乗るんでしょ？
いえ、大丈夫です。山登りはカロリーを使いますから。
そう。けど、無理はしないでいいからね。
We began discussing Madoka's upcoming new life as we ate.
でも、結構急よね。
そうなんです。お父さんもびっくりしたみたいで、もう転勤はないだろうって。
そうね。もうずっとお隣さんだもの。
それでこんな半端な時期に、
yeah.
面倒に合わせてくれればまだしもだったんですけど。
Give me a sec. That's my hair.
マドカさんのこと本当のお姉さんみたいに思っていたからありがとう。お待たせサイクルウェアにママチャリってなんかすごい変だね。
Don't say thatNormally, we'd go all out by the time we got to the highway, but we took our time today. Or rather, if Madoka went all out, I could not possibly kept up with you on this bicycle.
こういうのも結構いいもんだね。こういうのも結構いいもんだね。ゆっくりのんびりのサイクリングも。
Sorry about that. Thanks for being considerate.
そんなんじゃないって。本当にさ。雨でも降らない限り毎週のようにサイクリングしてきたけど、なんか毎回ガチだったし、それじゃあやっぱりさすがに疲れるよ。
I mean that's the point. Yeah, we've got rivals.
ライバルね。でも私はこういうのもいいと思うわよ。のんびりと喋りながらでもできるペースで。
Yeah, I feel youAgreed, and not just because it would be a while before we'd get the opportunity to do it again. I guess finally realized my partner was a girl. It was about time for us to end our silly competitions. Oh, these city bicycles are so heavy. It was obviously all harder to push heavy stuff uphill.It was a bit crazy to do this with the city bicycle that was designed to be stable and sturdy above all else. Damn, I feel my legs are about to cramp. I'm not sure. Acted as though I was out of breath and shook my head. Actually, I was out of breath. Yeah. Finally, there. I did my best to even my breath and barely stay on my feet. Oh, shut up. But my master is your death.
ま、そういうことにしておこう。
When I finally felt like I could breathe again, I walked to her side. It was nice here, just as it always was. Though I'd never seen a single other person here. Look, I did her usual routine and threw up about the swamp. The weber I threw skipped off the surface three or four times. I wasn't really good at this either, but I was better than her. I
noticed.
It doesn't have to be. go ahead.
Shinji からでいいよ。
Ladies first.
じゃあそうさせてもらおうかな。
Nonoka nodded towards her road bike.
私のこのロードだけどさ、まあ女子用ではあるんだけど、よかったらもらってくれない？
あ？
だってシンジの廃車になっちゃったんだし。
But what about you? Are you buying a new one?
うん、私東京に行ったらもう自転車なんか乗らないよ。私は多分シンジほど自転車が好きなわけではないし、というか一人だとその気になれないんだよね。シンジが。
And that's why you're giving it away?
うん。いいじゃない、女子用でも。色はおとなしい白だし。まあ、そのうち、ちっちゃくて乗れなくなっちゃうとは思うけど。
But I'm just the same. I won't try to find on my own.
シンジ、自転車基地なのに。
I'm not that into it. I give you an awkward smile.I don't think I will be able to get in the mood without you either. So I'd probably just end up rolling in my garage, even if I took it. Rotting in my garage, sorry.
So... Ah... Moo, the sun has turned off. It's probably too late to get out of here.
You took a while to get here too.
Shinji has worked hard. Then, let's go home.
No, wait, I still have something to say.
Sokka. Ja, dozo.
Madoka turned to me. I gulped. Madoka, I love you. As a girl. Madoka widened her eyes for a moment and smiled.
So nanda. Ureshi.
I thought you'd be more surprised.
Yeah, sore nari ni wa ne.男の子に好きなんて言ってもらうのも初めてだし、でもそうだったらいいななんて前から思っていたから、そんなに驚きはしない。
Really? For a while now?
そうだよ。
I just realized that day.
年は同じでも女子の方が少し成長が早いのかもね。
Yeah, it was slowly girls who became conscious of the difference between the sexes first. I'd been thinking of her as a rival forever. Now I feel so stupid. I had to tell you before I moved. I felt we'd meet again if I did.
つまり、恋人になれば?
Yeah, it sounded quite incredible when put to words. A girl that had always been beside me as a childhood friend would turn into my girlfriend.
うん、そうだね。私、彼氏がいるなら頻繁にこっちに来ちゃうもの。
Yeah! And I can go to Tokyo too! Marco's cheeks were somewhat reddish and it wasn't due to the second sun. I thought I'd already gotten used to her face long before, but in this moment she looked incredibly charming.
でも、告白だけじゃ恋人になったことにならない気がする。
Really? Right. I seize her shoulders. Then she says she brought a certain flash of déjà vu. Oh, too bad that, yeah, I can't, like, just remove text. I will think of something maybe later. I don't know. Also, yeah, he looks like he's, like, 13 or 14. But on that CG, well, you know, the different one, where he was, he looks like he's, like, 16 or something. Maybe that's, like, perspective or something, I don't know. Wow, I did not expect that. I ended up saying something stupid.
What?
It seems like it's saying it's like one phrase, you know, how to say, faster, so I will stop recording and try to do something about this. Right, it seems like it's working properly this time, so. Oh, I hope at least. Oh, I didn't expect that. I ended up saying something stupid. Fuck! Apparently not! I know what to do. So, maybe I should... Maybe? Give me a sec. No. Yeah, I don't know why. Yeah, yeah, oh, I think it's swept, yeah. Okay, let's... Okay, having to leave yourself, Madoka was probably even more anxious than me, and the difference of feeling was probably what pushed her back harder this time. I don't know, maybe this is like a bug or something. No way. Hey, Capo, now. Why? Right. well, Madoka blushed even harder. She was starting to look almost like a tomato. I might have been the same. Are you going to be okay on your own? I see what will happen. Yeah, you won't. I'm pretty sure you won't, yeah. I looked around. I shook my head. I guess that's true. Okay. Come to think of it, I did have like this like version like wine 0.00. Maybe there's like some sort of patch. Because I didn't see any like, you know, kind of update things on the Endeavor, just, you know, the, I don't know if they usually like you know, mention it there. But at least for 18 plus patch they mentioned there, so maybe they would mention it if there are some updates soon, eh? But I don't know, maybe that's because of that. I'm fine with waiting if it's just 5 minutes. It was unusual for her to be so embarrassed. I suppose that was proven now that we were a couple. Got it. We're going ahead then. No, she's totally gonna die. She's totally gonna die. Oh my fucking... She's so gonna die. I really don't know how to, like, you know, take screenshots without with that thing, because it's like, when I press, it's like immediately goes up, and cable settings, they're not helping, because I tried, well, you know, this, like, every settings, and I thought maybe I could, like, just, you know, press the keyboard button, and, like, you know, actually do stuff, but there is no, you know, this, like, thingy that, you know, allows you to take a screenshot. There is a thing, just I will show you in a moment. I just want to check again. Skip toggle backlog. Full screen. System. Audio and other. There is like this like thing. Snapshot or whatever. But yeah, it also takes with the text. So. I looked behind me multiple times as I walked away. Madoka stood in the same place by the swamp watching me. Without a cry to the sky, they flew down the hill. This time my feelings were the far opposite of the other day. It was a cry of joy. The first girl I had ever loved dropped me back. And... we finally starting, I assume.
Damn it. Haneru dokoro ka saisho no 1 kai de ochiru.
Madoka continued to throw pebbles at the ponds.
Sorosoro koppeta ga atsui no mo hita kana.
Not at the moment.
Yada. Nanka 笑いがこみ上げる
Madoka still seemed unable to contain herself. There was no way she could show it to Shinji.
本当嬉しかったな さっきは言ってくれて
Just when did she first feel attracted to him? Shinji said it was the other day, but truth be told, it wasn't that wrong for Madoka either. She thought of him as someone of the same sex when she was younger too. They weren't that different physically after all. It was probably because of how they totally lost themselves when cycling, which wasn't exactly the most romantic activity. But the difference between the two grew more and more apparent. And when Madoka realized it, she could no longer look at Shinji the same way. It was an odd feeling. It was she suddenly so interested in a boy that she had already known for ages. His face, expression, mannerism, voice, words, attitude, smell, everything affected her. It was only a matter of time before she realized that it was actually love. But Shinji showed no hint of the same. All he seemed interested in was cycling. There was no reason to rush, so Madoka thought that was fine. They have and always would be together after all. But the situation with her death work changed all of that in an instant. Madoka still planned to keep coming back to Sakura no Mori. But there was no denying that the time they spent together would decrease significantly. And with that, Shinji might start getting friendly with other girls. And that made her extremely anxious. But then, Shinji confessed to her. Now she was confident they'd be alright even in a long-distance relationship. Not that she had any experience with that, but she was still sure in her heart.
Shinji, daisuki.
Alright. A boy that had been with her almost since she was born. She felt like she'd remain together no matter what happened from now on.
Shinji.
Right. She's so gonna die. The pond quietly swallowed her words. They called it a pond, but the water here was almost eerily transparent. Transparent? Transparent, I guess. Translucent, maybe? The evening sun shines through gaps in the trees, making the surface sparkle. It was beautiful.
Soro-soro, atashi mo ikou kana?
And I assume she wants, and will actually die in the place. Somehow. But just as those words left her lips... Is the guy gonna stop anytime soon? Or do I have to press anything? Yeah. Also, I may be imagining that. I'm gonna even check. not. Is it heat? I don't know, but just kind of maybe tone of voice or something. She raised her voice, but received no response as the creepy laugh continued. Both, actually, yeah. It was beyond disturbing, as a way. It felt like someone was making her listen to him on purpose, but she had no idea why. Madoka looked around, searching for whoever the voice belonged to. But she would soon grow to regret doing that instead of instantly running away. When she finally spotted it, the silhouette was already upon her. The pack swept Madoka's slender body off its feet. When she came to her senses, she realized she was already partially submerged in the water. Since her quick thinking, she managed to avoid inhaling it. That could have made her instantly lose consciousness. But her anxiety over her current situation made it hard for her to hold her breath. Madoka did everything she could to stand up, but could not. Someone was on top of her. And... I mean, it's pointless to... Yeah. And the hands were on her throat. This person was trying to kill her. The problem of fear rose from the pit of her stomach. She'd never felt such a clear and violent emotion before. Her body started to sound the warning bells for oxygen deprivation. Her head began to ache. Her lungs felt like they were tearing themselves apart from the rival muscles stopping and forcing her to breathe. The water was shallow, she just needed to raise her head a little to be able to catch her breath, but she couldn't move a muscle to do so. The presence strengthened her strength and her the grip. Okay. Will it actually matter? I don't think so, but crazy face. Yes, crazy face is like the most logical option actually. She threw her hands forward to scratch as her assignment's face, but maybe her arms short enough. Well, not long enough. Yeah. Ah, no. But it seemed like she couldn't quite boast enough strength, and the person easily dodged her swing. I see. It doesn't matter. After having spent most of her life cycling, she was confident in the strength of her legs, except the person had the weight on her knees, making it impossible for her to move them in that position. Yeah, GG. She gathered what little of her strength remained and tried to force her silent hand away from her throat, but with an iron grip they held firm, not budging an inch despite her best efforts. She dug her nails into the person's skin, but not even that had any effect. With no options left, Madoka started to give in to the darkness. But in that moment she realized something, though it may just be a hallucination from her lack of oxygen. Oh, protect you, Madoka. Right. Do you disappear yourself? Apparently not. Shinji will come. Alright. I know it's... I'm certain. Because Shinji... You've always been there. Standing at my side. Thinking of me. They could actually waste it. So I know. So I know.
Rescue me, Shinji!
Yeah. Yeah. Sorry, that time I just laughed. Laughing is just eat. Yeah, it's awfully sad, right? Huh? Madoka said she'd catch up with me. It was so awesome I saw that I didn't realize she wasn't beside me until I got all the way home. I mean, I was even screaming into the sky. Good thing there were no other people on the mountain path. Did we somehow pass each other without noticing? I looked up at the house to see the lights still burnt on in her room. There was no way she could get lost on the road we traveled hundreds of times. I'm back!
お帰りなさい。あら、何かいいことでもあったの？ずいぶんニコニコ顔で。
あ、really? I said I'd like him down, but even I could hear a smile on my voice.
そうよ。
It's nothing much. I took a shower and sat down at the table. It was already time for dinner. Let's begin!
いただきます。
Delicious!
どうしたの？いつものハンバーグじゃない。
Right. Oh, it feels extra delicious today?
それはどうも。
兄さん、すっかり元気になったみたい。
Right. Not for long.
マドカさんの引っ越しが決まってから、元気をなくしていたから、ちょっと心配だったの。
Yeah. Thanks, Katsuna.But I'm alright now. Maruko's windows remain dark even after we finished dinner. I felt a shiver on the of anxiety for a moment, but my blissful elation quickly pushed it away. Well, she'll be moving out tomorrow. Maybe she suddenly remembered something she was missing and went out shopping. Other than that, I wanted to save this moment. It reminded me of sucking on lemon drop. But it was a lot sweeter than that and it didn't disappear nearly as fast. Or maybe This was more like a snowball of happiness that rolled down a mountain slope, getting bigger and bigger with each revolution. We kissed. I never thought of kissing a girl before, and I never dared to imagine doing it with my childhood friends. I'd have likely thought the very idea was some sort of joke, but now I couldn't think of doing it with anyone but Madoka. She was my girlfriend now, no one else. We're a couple now. Yeah, I've got to find that paradigm drop after all. I'll start it as soon as the new semester starts.I'd save not for a road bike, but instead for funds to travel to Tokyo. Maybe I should buy a camera too. It probably helps for communicating all long distance. Then... I jumped out of bed in response to the violent knocking on the door. What?
Shinji-kun.
Mrs. Miyako? What happens? She looked very tense.
Madoka-chan ga mada kaeranai rashikute.
I hurried downstairs to find my dog's parents there. The two looked like ghosts.
Shinji-kun, 今日は二人でサイクリングに行ったんだろう。
Madoka's death started with no introductory remarks. Yes.
詳しく聞かせてくれないか。
Like what?
最後に Madoka と一緒にいたのが、多分君になるんだよ、Shinji-kun。
I tried processing the information, but Madoka's death continued.
まず、今日はどこに行ったんだね?
I'm to the marsh.
Uma?
There's a small path leading to it from the highway in Mibukayama.
それから?
Then... I followed his words.
帰りはどうしたんだ? 一緒には帰らなかったんだろう?
I told him Madoka wanted to stay for longer.It sounded kind of fishy without giving the reason, but the two didn't push me for it. They were silent for a few moments.
Yoshi, すぐにそこに行こう。
あなた、待って。もう警察を呼んだ方がいいわ。
The police? I gave them puzzled looks. Everyone in the room regarded me with somewhat peculiar sympathetic eyes.
そうだな。
Wait, why is the police? Madoka's mother took out her cell phone and went outside.Madoka's dead turned to me.
君らが別れてからおよそ 3-4 時間は経っているが、その間、マドカから何の連絡もないんだ。そして、こちらからの電話も通じない。あの子の身に何かが起きたんだ。それはもう、間違いない。
He looked like he was in severe pain. Something... What exactly? What could have possibly happened to her? I was confused and unable to put one and one together.
すぐ来てくれるそうよ。
Heavy silence took over the room as we waited for the police. I kept thinking of how we split up. The joy of hearing our feelings requited. The sensation of our lips touching. Those memories were so real, I felt like I could literally touch them just moments before, but... They felt vacuum and misty now matter... no matter... What? What? Now...No matter how hard I concentrated, I guess, yeah, they just forgot to know. Almost as though it was some sort of delusion on my part. We headed straight to Mibukayama as the police arrived. Not even they knew about the marsh, so I had to lead the way. I'd have gone the either way, so this was lucky in a sense. I was still a kid, but I didn't want to leave my girlfriend's fate completely to the police. The sun flashlight pierced through the mountain darkness. I shouldn't have been out of breath from coming here in the car, but for some reason I had trouble breathing. My body felt numb, so I had caught a cold, making it hard to walk. What was up with this sensation? It's here. The two policemen began shining the flashlights left and right. The place you were pointing at just now.
Nanda ne.
Could you return the light over there for a bit?
Gotchika.
Oh yeah.
A circle of a rim of light shined in the darkness. Mrogo's road bike. I heard a bone-chilling sound. In the back of my mind, it seemed I still believed that Madoka would be right. That this would turn into a fine story we'd laugh about in the future. I clung to that hope. But the sound I'd heard was most likely the undoing of that hope.
今度は沼の方にライトを当ててみろ.
Hi.
A kind of light piece pierced through the darkness. Stopped and focused on a single location. And everyone let out a scream. Narrates. Madoka! I forgot, yeah. Yeah.
Konna koto ga okoru nante hontou ni shinjiraremasen. O tsuya to osoushiki ga owatte mo mada kokoro no soko kara wa mitomeru koto ga dekinai desu. Madoka-san ga orosarete shimatta nante. お姉さん のように慕っていたまどかさんが亡くなって、私も言葉にできないほど悲しかったです。何より切なく映ったのは、ご両親の嘆きようでした。お通夜の時も、お葬式の時も、おばさんはずっと泣き崩れていました。おじさんは、目を真っ赤にして何かにずっと耐えていました。そして兄さんも、兄さんの様子は私には見ていられないほどでした。まどかさんたちは日曜には引っ越すてはずになっていて、お葬式が終わると隣の家はすぐに空っぽになってしまいました。私にとっては物心ついた頃からのお隣さんです。引っ越してしまっただけでも言ってみれば欠落感があったのですが、そして空っぽといえばダメ、兄さん出てきてくれないよ。
困ったわね。せめて食べてくれないと、シンジ君本当に倒れちゃうわよ。食事はドアのところに置いてくれたわね。
うん。
明日の朝になってもそれが残っていたら、もうドアを蹴破ってでも中に入るわよ。
できるの？
やるしかないわよ。
そうだね。
今のシンジ君を支えてあげられるのは初音ちゃんとママしかいないんだから。本当に犯人が憎らしいわ。憎んでも憎みきれない。犯人は全てを壊してしまったのよ。 マドカちゃん一家はもちろん、シンジ君の心まで。
兄さんはきっとマドカさんのことが好きだったんだよね。
え、そうね、きっと好きだったんでしょう。覚えてる？マドカちゃんが殺された夜、シンジ君が妙に嬉しそうにしていたのを。
あ、うん。
あの時、多分二人の間にいいことがあったのだと思うのよ。気持ちが通じ合ったというような。でもその直後に。あんなことに、あんまりかわいそうだわ。惨殺されたまどかちゃんはもちろん、シンジ君も。
このまま兄さんは本当に壊れてしまうのかもしれない。それは私にとって何よりも怖いことでした。そんなことを想像したとき、私は一つの決心をしたんです。私が兄さんの支えになる。ただ問題は、兄さんにとって私が支えとなれるかどうかということですが。
Realize I was staying in the White Seal now hospital room. It might sound like I'm making it up, but I really didn't remember how I got there. I glanced to my side only to see a drip attached to my arm. They told me I fainted from malnourishment. Only think of it, I couldn't quite recall it in anything lately. When was it that I last ate? I shut myself into my room and barely even went to the bathroom, most likely because I didn't put anything in my body to begin with. Miss Miyako took leave from work and nursed me. Kasuna too skipped her club activities and looked after me in the meantime. The two were crying in the side of my bed when I woke up. I was the one who caused the tears. My guilt was probably the only thing that kept me going. I couldn't make them sad any further. This is how it usually works, actually. The only thing after when a person is breaking down, and for example, someone there is actually who cares about them, the only thing that will actually keep them going, either guilt or desire to, you know, revenge or something. I went to school for the first time in a long while. The rumors of the incident seemed to have spread, and everyone watched me wearily from afar in class. Even my best friend Sabaya seemed to have trouble coming up with anything to say. I acted as though I listened to the class, but I felt empty inside. Only Breeze saw that Hatsune and Miss Miyako wouldn't be sad. That is all. I didn't aspire to anything else. I didn't hope for anything else. Later I heard that the police actually suspected me at first. But Madoka's parents vehemently defended me, and eventually the police seemed to give up on that angle. I felt somewhat grateful for that, but also didn't care at the same time. Maybe, just maybe, when I will be doing a review of that game, like later down the line, you will know something else. Madoka's road bike was left in my house for some reason. I had no recollection, but Madoka's dad apparently handed it to me after the funeral.
形見として受け取ってくれないか。
That was what he said, apparently. Maroko wanted to give it to me too, and I refused, but it ended up in my hands anyway.
Tain してからというもの、兄さんは三度の食事はちゃんと取ってくれて、表面的には元気を取り戻したように見えます。けれど、それは本当に表面だけの話で、心の中に変わりはないようです。表情をなくしている兄さんの顔を見れば、それはわかります。悪 笑い声のあった食卓がなんだか遠い昔のようです。兄さんのことどうにかしてあげたいとは思っているんです。でも私にはどうすることもできない。そのことも分かっています。朝の登校の時も兄さんはほとんど口を聞きません。マドカさんと三人で歩いている時は雑談の声も絶えませんでしたけど。
I felt like I was starting to forget how to speak. Tokyo didn't offer anything particularly unusual, but when Cherry Blossoms bloomed in Arena, I tried reading something from our Japanese textbook aloud and realized it's been a while since I heard my own voice. I had shut myself into my own shell, ignoring both my family's thoughtfulness and my friend's sympathy. Why did it have to be this way? Why did it have to be this way? I knew it was my fault. If only...
先に帰っていいよ。
I had insisted for us to go back together. But I didn't. Madoka... The one that had always been beside me, but now she was nowhere at all.
何があったって立ち直れる。私はそんなシンジのことは。
That wasn't true. I probably couldn't recover from this. I wasn't strong. I needed support. Support. At times I felt as though I had been forgetting something important. Something. What did I forget? Give me a sec. Okay. I was anxious when I left here at the pond. I didn't pay much attention to it because of how happy I was, but... Why did I feel that back then? It'd been there hundreds of times, I knew she wouldn't get lost. So what was it my subconsciousness was trying to tell me back then? Madoka. Time slowly passed by. Summer drew near, but my body seemed like it lost the ability to sense heat. Cornus fed when in direct sunlight. The mind had an undeniable effect on how one's body behaved. I lost my parents, and then I lost my lover. Was I cursed? By something. It was as though a jolt of electricity passed through me as I saw it. Not because it surprised me. I understood. Right. Give me a sec. This might be bad. It's looking at us. Run! I said it was after me back then. But it most likely it had targeted Madoka instead. The anxiety from that time lingered in my heart. I knew it. I knew about it. Come. Come at me! But the monster remained motionless like it didn't even hear me. It said the family and a couple that had been nearby quickly moved away from me. I broke into a dash. But the monster had already disappeared by then.
Hi, どうぞ.
Keith. You think that my ability to see the sphere of things is connected to the aptitude of a hero?
What?
Kid reacted in his usual laid-back way, even when the conversation came out of nowhere. He sat down on the sofa, holding his nose.
座れば? そうだね。
What did you mean exactly?
つまり?
You think heroes can defeat those monsters?
多分ね。
How? I drew my face close to his.
僕は知らないよ。でも、僕にそのことを教えてくれた人が そう言っていたんだ。
What? Who's that?
さあ、僕も知らない人だけど。シンジ君、正義のヒーローになるつもりなの？
Yeah.
頑張って。
It consoled me in the same way as always. I didn't care about heroes, but could become one of its mains. I could avenge Madoka's death. It didn't matter if I became a villain either. Ever since then, when I was outside in school, I started to look for monsters everywhere. Not like there was anything I could do even if I found them. I wasn't actually a hero. Others started noticing my weird behavior, and before long, no one talked to me anymore. Tsubaya was the only friend who still tried to treat me the same way, but I barely talked to him myself. Madoka. Besides, we are set on the side of reality, the world of operations and monsters. On the other side of reality, sorry. And once that happened, I began to realize that the boundary between dreams and the real world was melting as well.
ねえ、シンジ、今度店に付き合って。
Sure, but what do you plan to buy?
替えのチューブ。
You can get those online.
いいじゃない。お店に行くのが楽しいんだって。
ん？
それに、店で買ってあげないと中川も潰れちゃうよ。
You really think we should be worrying about them?
そこまで心配してこそ、お得意様なんだって。
Okay, whatever you say.
ねえ、信じてば。おい、シンジ！待ってよ、そんな先に行かないでってば。シンジの方がもう早いんだから。シンジ？シンジ、どうして行っちゃうの？どうして行っちゃうのよ。
That isn't it, Madoka. It was you who hurried off and left me. Don't do it. Don't leave me behind, Madoka. Madoka!
どうして来てくれなかったの？
It was something like, why didn't you come or something? In Japanese.
Madoka さんが亡くなって、しばらくすると。兄さんの目つきが目に見えておかしくなったようでした。いつも何かを探すみたいにキョロキョロしているんです。
シンジ君はきっとマドカちゃんを探しているんだわ。
ママはそんなことを言っていて、私もそうかもしれないと思うようになりました。
お医者さんに連れて行った方がいいのかしらね。
私は正直、お医者さんが兄さんを救えるとは思えません。でも、だったら、一体、誰に救えるんでしょうか。
ねえ、シンジ君、聞いてちょうだいな。マドカちゃんはもう死んでしまったのよ。その現実は認めないと。
ママは多分意を決してそう言ったのだと思うのです。でも兄さんの反応はちょっと意外で。何を当然のことを。そんな顔つきでした。
I know that.
そう。ならいいのだけど。でも、じゃあ、シンジ君は一体何を探しているの？正直に答えてくれないかしら。
Right. I'm looking for monsters.
その兄さんの返答がママをますます困惑させたのは私にも想像がつきました。 ママはロンドンにいるパパと長いこと電話をして兄さんのことで相談をしています。でも悪霊か、前にも似たようなことは言っていたんだよね。その時は確か影とか言っていたはずだけど、だから私としてはママのように考えることはできませんでした。まどかさんが亡くなったから言い出したわけではないんです。その前からたまに口にしていたことで、それはそれとしても兄さんはどうして悪霊を探しているんでしょう。ひょっとするとまどかさんは悪霊に殺された、そう考えているのでしょうか。でもまどかさんは、
what is this? It may have sounded weird, but I felt awake for the first time in a long while. The number of monsters in our town increased almost as though answering my call. These bastards. How was I supposed to tell which one of them was the culprit when there were so many? It's been a while since I became able to see them. But they never appeared in such large numbers. I just glimpsed one or two in a week at best. What made the numbers increase so much? I ignored Katsuna and followed one of the monsters to the opposite direction from our school. For some reason I couldn't quite catch up to it. It didn't seem like it even saw me, yet its body would twist and move as soon as I got close. It was almost as though it was a thin sheet of paper that twisted and turned in the wind.
Nisa, wait! Nisa!
You've got to go to school, Hatsune.
Nisa!
There were tears in Katsuna's eyes. But... I'm sorry, Katsuna. I'm already too far gone. They're still around us. Monsters, just what are these things? Katsuna regarded me with tears running down her face. But instead of tearing up again, her eyes lit up with a new sense of resolve.
Huh? 悪霊がいるとしても、 マドカさんは悪霊に殺されたわけじゃない。だからねえ兄さん、警察を信じて、あとは犯人が見つかるの。
Okay. I stopped listening. Right. Of course. I headed to school to put Hatsune's mind to rest. Got guilty for making her wait. I was right without reason, but the teacher didn't even say anything. It seemed like everyone at the school had started treating me like an aberration at this point. That made me feel awakened in a whole other sense. It was true that these monsters look like they could be murdering people left and right, but it was also true that Madoka was killed by the serial killer. I learned this some time after the incident, but obvious strangulation marks were discovered on Madoka's neck. So why was I so obsessed with these things? I was at school before Katsuna had the time to come and pick me up. Hesterman stepped further as I passed by the gates heading home for starters. It took me a bit of self-convincing, but I ended up using Madoka's road bike. It was a bit smaller than my previous one, but it wasn't comfortable to ride. Her dad gave it to me as memento, It's a shame to let it rot in the garage. Speaking of Momentus, I had one more. I like the bike, I actually asked for this one. Could I have the ribbon that Madoka always used to dye her hair? It was just a piece of clothes, yet it felt oddly warm when I touched it. I have the house without even changing. I studied quite a bit, my body was very much out of shape after such a long break. But I paid it no mind and continued towards the pond. I pushed the road back deeper along the mountain pass. My pants stuck in my sweaty legs, making it hard to walk. There I felt kind of damp, as though it was about to rain. I hadn't been here since that day. But I was avoiding this place. I was so obsessed with those monsters. When I touched Madoka back then, with her leaves about her shoulders, I almost remembered something. And now I knew what it was. I'll protect you, Madoka. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, Madoka. I failed to keep my promise. Monsters, for me, they might have just been a convenient escape. Those are culprits. A mind that breathes the same air as me. God damn it. It's given me a bit of peace if he got caught, but it was already a month since the police were none the wiser. The investigation didn't seem to progress at all. It probably was too late at this point. There was a culprit. Not a monster that normal people couldn't see or touch. He was. So, you gonna stop like anytime soon? Thanks. Who's there? The voice remained unchanged even after my scream. Was it laughing? Maybe crying. It drew away from me as I stood dazed. Wait! I saw it darting through the trees. I thought in my eyes for a moment. They naked? The person wore only underwear and something like a bag on the head? A pervert? I sped up. But I couldn't catch them, rather they were getting further and further away. They were light on the feet and while I seemed heavy. Fuck! It's the damn sticky pants! Wait! My legs gave out and I felt my knees. There was nothing but forest around me, I couldn't hear anything anymore. I hit the ground with my fist. It didn't hurt much, so I continued to beat the ground until I finally felt the pain. My breathing sounded like that of a wild beast. Tears welled up in my eyes. I... Yeah, I'm not gonna scream. Or maybe I will. Yeah, I'm gonna save. I should have been more emotional in that regard, but what can I say? It's only 8. So I won't be like that loud. Madoka. Madoka. I wanted to see her so much. I'm so sorry for being unable to protect you. It won't be enough to make up for it. It won't bring you back. But at least. I'll kill you. I should have taken the screenshot of that, but okay. Epilogue. Okay!
Osoiwane. 警察に電話した方がいいのかしら？
警察？
なんか胸騒ぎがするのよ。やっぱり電話しましょう。
But as soon as mom picked up her phone, we heard Shinji's voice in the foyer.
もう遅いじゃん。あら、 どうしたの？そんなびしょ濡れになって。
Yeah, I didn't take an umbrella with me.
どこに行っていたの？
Just around.
ちょっとじゃわからないでしょ？
Mom seemed unusually angry. She regarded her with somewhat sad eyes. Wait, I want to clean my bike first.
どうぞ。
Marocco's memento. Thank you for the food.
いただきます。
Zayo and Zina began again, but Mom seemed to be still bothered by the earlier conversation.
それで、今日はどこに行っていたの？
The place where Madoka was killed.
どうしてそんなところに？
Why? Because she was killed. Mom seemed to be unable to respond to Shiji's calm words. Kasumi kept an eye on Shiji's face a shade. His expression had become completely empty after Madoka passed away. His eyes moved quickly when he was looking for his monsters, but there was no strength in them. But now, he looked different. He was just sitting in silence as usual, but Kasumi didn't miss a single change in his countenance? I know. Just what had happened to him today? Kasumi? Your heart almost stopped. This was the first time she reacted to her brother like that. I'm okay now. I got over it. Shinji looked down as he repeated his words. I found something to support me.
Sasae? Sasae wo mitsuketa. Toyu nii-san ga doushite sonna ni kanashige na no ka watashi ni wa wakarimasen deshita. そしてこの日を境に兄さんは確かに治ったようでした。でもそれは私が期待していたのとは違っていました。兄さんは元の兄さんに戻ったわけではない。次第にそのことが分かったんです。兄さんは常に何かを探しているようでした。でもそれは以前言っていたような悪霊ではないようです。では何を探しているのか、それは私にも教えてくれませんけれど、やっぱり私は兄さんの支えになることはできないのだと思います。私では兄さんを救うことができない。だったら一体どうしたら兄さんは救われるのでしょう。兄さんが救われる日は、ずぶ濡れになって戻ってきた夜以来、兄さんはずっと落ち着いたようでした。ママは安心したようですが、私はむしろ少し落ち着きません。今私の前にいる兄さんはもう昔の兄さんではない、別の人。でも私は兄さんのことが、
Why dance in the sky? My head hurts extremely badly. That shouting by my voice refused to leave my lungs. Only bubbles escaped my mouth. It's fire in the bright light eventually disappearing above my head. Suddenly realized it wasn't the light that was causing my intense headache. I couldn't breathe. My lungs kept shrinking, refusing to expand. My head swelled up in exchange, feeling with even more pain. Is he like reliving what she felt? It was only a matter of time before it exploded if this kept up. My lungs needed air. The surface of the water was right in front of my eyes. All I had to do was raise my face a little. I tried standing up, but realized I couldn't do that either. What were those hands? They were around my neck. They held me down with ungodly strength. I struggled with everything I had, but they didn't move an inch. I needed air. Ripples covered the shallow water surface as I struggled. I rolled my eyes to a little to see someone's face. Who was that? I let go of the hands and tried reaching out to the face. My hands no longer moved. I couldn't feel them anymore. My strength began leaving my body. The torturous headache disappeared as though never having been there. The violent water surface also combed and even out. Couldn't see the buckle of air rising in the light anymore. Nor was it peace. Chapter 1, Tono Kana. Okay. And that's where I will take a break. Well, that was super long prologue. Yeah, it's like 5 hours or something. Like, holy shit. Yeah, like... Yeah, I stopped here, then started at around 5. And like, right now is... Yeah. Right now is 8. So yeah, that's around 5 hours. And that's with my reading, which is like, you know, pretty fast. But yeah, I guess that's that. So yeah, that's pretty interesting. Let's see how Manga Gamer will... Manga Gamer, right? Manga Gamer, I think Manga Gamer. How they will react in terms of, like, will they, you know, say something to me? If not, then, yeah, as I said, I would like to do common route and one routes, but then I wouldn't do anything else because I kind of understand, yeah. I guess, yeah. If not, then, yeah, chat reviews, and, yeah. So, yeah, see you next time.